guys, and welcome back to another episode of Goal Presents What's in My Fridge. What I found in my freezer, the gold oozy cheesy corn bites. Everyone suddenly in a mood to have something cheesy, but I don't want to make this just as these corn bites. So I'm actually going to turn these into some beautiful little canapes. There are two ways of actually cooking these frozen cheesy bites. You can either deep fry them or you can air fry them. I prefer air frying them, so I'm going to preheat my air fryer and I'm going to pop them in for about 12 to 15 minutes. And till then, I'm going to get all my other ingredients to top these canapes up ready. So for this recipe, you need some corn, which I've boiled. We've got some onions. I'm going to be showing you how to make some caramelized onions. Some sugar, cheese, spring onion, parsley, some red chili peppers, some butter, some chili flakes, some cherry tomatoes, some dried herbs, oil, salt, chili, and some broccoli. Just to get that extra nutrition for the family, we're just gonna pop some broccoli on top. So the first thing that we're gonna make, and I'm gonna teach you, and honestly, this is one of my secret recipes, which you can make at home and you can keep. It's a cheese sauce or a cheese dip. It's really nice for adults and kids. You just need to have a pan, some cream, and two different types of cheese. If you have any hard cheeses lying in the fridge, don't waste that. You can use them in this. Any mixed cheeses work. So I'm putting some cream. You need to melt your cream. Add in your cheese. So we just want all this to come together. This is a really nice thing to make and keep in the house. It can be used as a cheese spread. So now that our cream and cheese has nicely melted, you can see the consistency. We're gonna switch off the gas, and that's how simple it is. Add a little bit of your mixed herbs. And some chili flakes. Some pepper. You don't need to add any salt because the cheese already contains salt. And just take it out in a bowl. And that's ready. The next thing that I'm going to show you is how to make caramelized onions at home. So a lot of us are constantly struggling with caramelized onions. All that you need to do is peel and wash your onions and slice them thin. Switch on your gas, again a little bit of oil, and some butter, all these things that I'm teaching you are things that I make at home and I keep in my fridge, so you'll always find caramelized onions, you'll find this easy cheese sauce, and obviously you know you'll find some gold products in my freezer. Spread your onions out, and the trick is to put a little bit of salt for that perfect caramelization. Okay, so while the onions are getting caramelized, we're also going to quickly saute our corn. Now the reason I'm using corn is you can find it in your freezer, it's easily available at home. Plus our oozy cheesy corn bites also have corn in it. It'll enhance the flavor and it'll just bring everything together. So a little bit of butter, some oil, we'll chop up some fresh parsley. now that the oil and the butter is nice and hot, we're going to add our corn. Season it with a little bit of pepper, some dried herbs. So as you can see, all the elements that we're making for this dish, we are enhancing the flavor of the product, and we're also adding herbs and spices in each element so that when it all comes together, it's perfectly flavored and perfectly balanced. So now that the corn is well seasoned, has a little bit of butter and herbs, I'm adding some fresh parsley. Just mix it all up and make sure you switch off your gas when you add the fresh parsley. And some fresh spring onions as well. So it's herby and it's got corn and it's got a little bit of butter. And just like this, it's such a delicious snack. So it's herby, it's delicious, and just like that, it's such a delicious, nutritious snack. So let's get back at our caramelized onions. And now we're going to be adding some sugar. So what the sugar does is it actually caramelizes it and gives it some color. One by one, we've been prepping all our ingredients. We've got our cheesy sauce, we've got the herby corn, we've got some boiled broccoli. These gorgeous red chilies are in season. Again, something that I always have in my fridge. I'm just going to slice it up. So these will go as a garnish, and some cherry tomatoes. So I'm just going to cut our cherry tomatoes in half. That the onions are nicely caramelized, they're gooey, they're crispy. What we're gonna do is take them out in a bowl. You can cool these down and store them in a jar and then keep them in your fridge for up to almost 2 weeks. So now we have all our ingredients ready. So we've taken out our oozy cheesy corn bites. Make sure that they're frozen and they're not at room temperature. We're going to preheat our air fryer at 180 degrees for 10 minutes. So we'll just brush the oozy cheesy corn rice with some oil. I'm using sesame oil, you can use olive oil or sunflower oil. Make sure you brush it on both sides. So it's been 15 minutes and the oozy cheesy corn bites in the air fryer have come out beautiful and golden, like you can see the color. And this is what I prefer at home. I prefer using the air fryer other than deep frying them. So now that we have all our ingredients ready and the oozy cheesy corn bites have come out of the air fryer, I'm going to show you how you can make this simple dish into a really nice exotic one. So spread your cheese sauce at the base. We have some satay sticks. You can use toothpicks if you don't have satay sticks and just pierce them and place them. Now I'm going to be putting a little more of the cheese so that all the toppings will stick to your canapé. This is really nice for a dinner party, or if you have children coming over, you'd love to eat this. We add a little bit of corn Again, we want to enhance the taste of the dish. We'll be adding a little bit of the caramelized onion. We'll be also adding a little bit of boiled broccoli. A wedge of cherry tomato. It's almost like a little salad on a canopy. And some freshly chopped parsley. Here you have an easy oozy corn cheesy bite recipe which has turned into a delicious nutritious canopy. It's about thinking innovatively, it's about coming up with delicious, nutritious and pretty looking dishes. I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe and try it at home. Do let us know in the comments below. I will catch you next week on another episode of Gold Presents What's in My Fridge. I'm gonna go eat. See you soon.